Hey everybody, it's Sonic Wolf and welcome back to more Earthbound. I feel really tired today. I don't really know why. It's like one of these days where you feel extremely tired in the morning and you don't want to get out of bed. Screw you, hints. I'm not gonna listen to some hints and crap. I've actually got a different capture device, which I'm kind of worried about. Which is actually a game capture HD, which is a bulkier capture device. And it's also a capture card where you can record games on composite cables and component cables. So that could be good. I can actually record PlayStation 2 games, but once I actually try to record it, it just doesn't seem to work. Oh god, there's a taxi. Run, get out of here. I don't really care. I kind of forgot where I'm supposed to go. I don't have my book with me. I do remember you go into the museum. Wait, how much? Wait, why do I have $18? Wait a minute. I'm trying to remember. I did a practice run, but I just kind of forgot what to do. So I'm gonna have to guess. I'm supposed to go in the museum. Because I do remember for Pooh, you need the tiny ruby in order to access. I could spend a lot on just adjusting my inventory, but I'm just lazy. Yeah, I didn't want to adjust my inventory because I'm lazy. Anyway, let's sneak past. Oh, come on! I don't have to pay for this bullcrap. Oh, I mean, you know, pay for this bullshit. Anyway, let's just go through the door. There's not really much things here because there's not going to be a lot of fighting, which is a boring video, I will admit. But there's a few puzzles I'm gonna show you after this. So the samurai kid is here. So how did we even get that ruby gem? I honestly don't remember how we got it. Oh, okay, that's... Yeah, when I first did a practice run, I thought he just disappeared. Oh, hang on. So he's going to give us nothing. I thought he was gonna give me a piece of paper. Now we have the Shattered Man. This guy is actually very tough. When I did a practice run, I thought he was not too bad with the notes on there, but apparently he is annoying. Does he have any good things? No, he doesn't. Oh, maybe I can use Shield Killer. See how that works. And for Pooh, you don't have any goods, so I'm gonna do Mirror. What it will do is Pooh would actually replicate the mummy so that he can become the enemy, which would be himself. It's a little confusing, but we'll see how that works. It did not work. God damn it. Damn it, he didn't turn into the Shattered Man. Yeah, he can replicate enemies and you will not use Pooh during battle. His attacks and healing will be controlled by the AI, which sucks. Really wish you can control an enemy so that you can take an advantage of it. Paula, you do freezing. Yeah, freezing is effective against this guy. Also, I believe there is a glitch in the game after the game where if you leave one of these guys alive, yeah, you can only fight one at a time. Freeze beta. Paula use freeze gamma. Yay, it worked. Yeah, when I did a practice run, one of the characters died, and it sucks. Oh, so it gave us a mummy wrap. There's actually a one in two chance, basically 50% of you getting a mummy wrap. I really don't know what it does, but I'm guessing it stuns enemies. Ooh, vitality went up by one. More power. More power. I just love that catchphrase when you level up, you say more power. Okay. No! Oh no! Now I failed the glitch trick. Great. Now I won't be able to show it. I just had to find someone else who does it. What the glitch trick actually does after you defeat the game, and if you lose the battle, the screen would just go black, but you will hear music and sounds on there, and there is no way you can escape the ending. I was so, so pissed off that I couldn't even do the glitch trick. Okay, fine. We'll just get rid of you. Let's get some experience points. I've actually read on the Starman.net, which is a website for players of Earthbound. Oh god. This guy has really powerful attacks, so you want to be careful. Yay, freezing is really effective. Okay, so Ness is at 42. More power! Paul is at 35. More power! More power, giving me all the power! I've got the power! Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. I don't know how the song goes, but... anyway, let's read this special type of fossil or whatever it is. Now, this is going to be really handy. So, the Lost Underworld. So, if only the hawk eye can pierce the dark. You want to remember that. And this is the code. It looks like some kind of note for a pentagram. In a form of a star. You might want to remember that as well. But luckily, they're going to give you... wait, hold on. Oh, you talk to the person and he'll give you a piece of paper of it. You get lots of money from him. Wait, do we still have the paper? No, we do. Hang on. So it's more valuable than the gem. He also... wait, he didn't give us the paper? I did remember that you'll actually receive the paper with all the notes that are written on here. Yeah. I've already read these notes. And he does not give us a... oh, now he gives us the picture. God. You have to be at the door and then he will give... that is just very, very cryptic. How am I supposed to know that? Yeah, how am I supposed to know that? I mean, come on. Let's ignore these people. They are not really that helpful. Well, sort of, actually. So he's just mentioned about the museum. Blah, 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 blah. I don't care. Whoops. Oh, wait. Did I do something? I just hear the dun, 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 which indicates that you've unlocked something. Yeah, you hear that? I honestly don't know what I've unlocked, but I'm pretty sure it's kind of important. And he says nothing but useless crap. Anyway, let's get out the museum, and now we have a phone call. I kind of forgot there's a phone call here. So, Mr. Fork at the Scarabeo Central Museum. So, found something extraordinary. So, it's fantastic. It's outrageous. And that's it. Okay, so now we're going to have a bit of a choice here with the gameplay. You can either go to Scarabeo, which I'll show you in a few episodes, or we can finish the section in Foreside. So luckily, we have Pooh, so now we can use teleportation powers. So we're going to go to... not Summers. Yeah, teleport from Summers to Summers. That would be hilarious. Let's go to Foreside. And we run at 88 miles per hour. Back to the future, baby. Okay, so in here, we're going to go to the Dinosaur Museum. Now, I believe you have to go to the museum first and talk to the person in order to go to the next stage. I don't know exactly, but it kind of sounds like it. So we're gonna go to the museum. Wait, hold on. I remember you need to pay $20 to get in the museum. I really hate, you know, paying for expositions. Come on. Yeah, I know it's a reason to do it, but I just hate paying for expositions. Or whatever it is. So we're going to get $70 out, which is 20 for the museum twice, so that's 40, and $30 for the show ticket. So we have six extra dollars, so that will be $64 we need to get out of the bank account. There we go, 64, just like Mario 64 or any other Nintendo 64 games. I'll probably save in the next episode, because this one's going to be a two-parter, because, yeah, this one is actually a really long part, and also a really boring one. So we go in here, let's sneak past through the door. Five per person, that is just cruel. In summers, you need $3 a person, so that would be 12. And here, you need 20? Yeah, that's just unfair. The game, I do like the game, but it's very, God damn it, Photo Guy. To be honest, I was not actually expecting it. I did a practice run of this part, and I don't even remember or even know that the Photo Guy is in the museum. Yeah, to be completely honest, I think the Photo Guy is very disgraceful because he interrupts your gameplay and he ultimately serves no purpose. Yeah, take my word from it. He serves no purpose in the game, but just to interrupt your gameplay, he does not need to exist. Anyway, now that I got my anger out of the way and we've talked to this person where we need to have a signature from Venus, which is a new singer in the Tulipa, or the Tulipa, whatever. Yep, we're gonna pay for the show ticket and show them the ticket. Use. What's kind of funny is once I got in the stage, I actually went in this door and thought it was the backstage door, but no, it's actually the manager's office. I don't know, I thought that was pretty funny, actually. So, don't make me hurt so bad, and I'm not gonna do the commentary on it, because it's bad. What? They even used the word sexy on it. When I first played this, I was kind of shocked that they even put the word sexy on the text. I'm not even joking. Yeah, it's just like one of these NES games where they put the word hell in it, which is a bit of a shock, which is the first curse word in the entire existence. Well, kind of the game existence. Wait a minute, is that the person that went from the museum actually went on stage? I don't know, I just had to guess that because it's kind of the same person. Okay, so finally the stage performance is already finished. And okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the backstage with this person blocking our view. Can you just, yeah, just sidewalk? I really don't know if characters can do just normal walking or sidewalking in this game. Oh, you want an autograph? So she's going to sign it on a banana peel. It's very weird. Why would you sign on a banana peel instead of paper? Oh, this is a bonus. Ow! I was gonna do a smack sound effect, but I just hit my leg. Okay, that is a stupid mistake. I just hit my leg. Anyway, I would have to guess that she would actually slap Ness in the face, or yeah, because it did say smack on it. So now that we have a signed banana. So now we have 20 extra dollars and, oh, wait, hold on. I'm not going to go into the museum because I want to actually save because this is the part where a few of the characters in the game will die at the stage. So I'm going to rest in... Now, actually, we're going to rest in the desert because there is a house there which is free for you to rest. And that is actually good. But first, I'm going to... Anyway, I'm going to end this off here so I don't make you guys feel bored. Bye.